The iPhone 8 was released only a year ago in late 2017 as the successor to the iPhone 7 and a cheaper option to the $1,000 iPhone 10. Hey, how's it going? I'm Josh from 91Tech, and today we're taking a look at the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus in late 2018. Are they still worth buying? The iPhone 8 and 8 Plus were, in my opinion, very underrated phones, being just as fast and basically just as good as the iPhone 10, minus the bezel-less display. The 8 is the last iPhone ever to have the home button and Touch ID, and if that appeals to you, this is literally the best iPhone you can get with those features. And I know this does appeal to a lot of people, with the iPhone 10 seeming a bit foreign and unnecessary to some. This here is an iPhone 8 Plus, and is better than the smaller one, especially with the extra camera, lens, and a bigger battery, as well as an extra gigabyte of RAM. But if you don't like the 5.5-inch screen, then the 4.7-inch iPhone 8 might be a better phone to go for, with it being quite a bit cheaper as well as an added bonus. Overall, I would recommend the iPhone 8 Plus for the battery, camera, and faster speeds, but it really does come down mostly to which size you would prefer. The display is LCD and Retina, but that doesn't really mean much. Basically, for the vast majority of people, the screen looks fine. Everything on it looks good, there's no visible pictures, but for the enthusiasts out there, it obviously isn't going to match your standards, and you probably are going to want to buy a Samsung or the iPhone XS. But again, for almost everybody watching this video, the iPhone 8 looks great, and I was using an iPhone 10 for almost a whole year before switching to it, and frankly, I didn't mind it at all, and I would consider myself more tech-minded than most people, so take that as you will. The phone itself is very light and thin, especially in comparison to the iPhone 10 and XS. The frame uses aluminum over stainless steel, and while this takes away from the durability, some will prefer it because it doesn't scratch as easily and isn't too heavy. We have a glass back here for wireless charging, which is a great feature and one I really appreciate. However, it will break if you drop it too badly, so you might want to put a case on this thing. The iPhone 8 is water resistant with an IP67 rating, which is decent enough and will save you if you drop your phone in the toilet, assuming you don't flush it all the way down, I guess. The iPhone 8 again features the last home button on an iPhone and has very, very fast Touch ID. It's great, convenient, and to be honest, I think I still prefer this over Face ID, although it is a close call. The home button is capacitive, which means that it isn't actually a button, but will instead vibrate when you push it to mimic a click. This is the same as what we saw on the iPhone 7, and it feels good. Plus, less moving parts means less breakable parts, so I have no complaints here. The smaller iPhone 8 is actually the smallest iPhone Apple sells anymore, along with the iPhone 7, while the 8 Plus is the size of the XS Max, but without the big display. The 8 Plus for me always kind of required two hands, but I still found it worth it to use just for that battery life. The battery on the smaller iPhone 8 isn't too bad, and it should last you the day, but on the 8 Plus, it's amazing, and I was finishing the day at around 50%, which is insane because I use my phone quite a bit. I got the 8 Plus basically brand new, and battery life is going to vary user to user, but if you want a powerhouse, something that'll last you the day no matter what you throw at it, the 8 Plus is a really good option. And somehow the iPhone XR coming out this year is even better than the 8 Plus, although I won't go into that. In comparison, I usually finish the day with my iPhone XS at under 20%. Not great, it lasts okay, but still, I miss the better battery of the iPhone 8 Plus because it offered more security. If I had to do something late at night, maybe I need to quickly run out to the store or something, I didn't have to be a little worried that my phone was going to die on me. The camera on the iPhone 8 is pretty good, and similar to the 10. It'll do you just fine, and you really don't have to worry about getting bad shots because the phone won't. It isn't the best in the business for sure, but with its 12 megapixel sensor and up to 4K at 60 frames per second video recording, you won't need to worry at all. The iPhone 8 Plus does have a secondary telephoto lens, which provides you with 2x zoom and portrait mode shots. I'd say it's not a killer feature that you absolutely need if you're kind of stuck between the 8 and the 8 Plus, but it is nice to have, and portrait mode shots usually do look pretty good, which is nice. The selfie camera is 7 megapixels and produces fine selfies, although it doesn't have portrait mode for the front-facing camera, unlike the iPhone 10. And now I'll just show some quick examples from the camera, some pictures I took while I was using it. Thank you. When it comes down to it, the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus sound really good on paper, especially at the starting price of $600 on Apple's website. But how do they perform in real life? Well, with the A11 Bionic chip and 3GB of RAM on the Plus, as opposed to 2 on the smaller one, the iPhone 8 flies through any task you throw at it and seems to perform even better on iOS 12. It'll have support from Apple for at least another 4 years and probably won't start to feel slow for another 2 to 3. The iPhone 8 really excels in anything it does, and whether you're taking photos, playing games, or using social media, I honestly believe you'll be completely satisfied with the iPhone 8. It's the best phone that doesn't have the iPhone 10 design, and if that's what you want, you really can't go wrong. I'd always also recommend getting the 8 over the 7 as well, due to it being, in my opinion, a lot better for not that much more money, but that really comes down to personal preference and what your budget looks like. $600 isn't terrible for the iPhone 8, but I'd really suggest looking around for some deals, especially on contract or used on eBay/Craigslist. I've seen iPhone 8s go for like $400 on eBay, and that's a killer deal. You'll probably see them go for a little more than that most of the time, but look around. iPhone 8 Pluses, of course, are more expensive, being bigger, and which one you want really is up to you. Again, you have the bigger screen, slightly faster speeds, and the better camera on the 8 Plus. The big thing here is I would recommend buying one of them, either the iPhone 8 or 8 Plus, because I think this is one of the best valued phones out there if you like iOS. The only thing I'd say is that if you're still not 100% into having a home button and bezels in 2018, maybe look into the iPhone XR, as it'll be costing $750 come October, and is very close to as good as the iPhone XS, just with a lower quality display, and a couple other drawbacks here and there. Again, I'll say for like the 15th time, if you're looking into buying the iPhone 8 or 8 Plus, I'd say go for it. It's a great phone, and I really enjoyed my time with it. I used the 8 Plus for about a month, and I really liked it. I actually kinda didn't want to give it up for the iPhone XS, but, you know, had to do what I had to do. With that all being said, I'm pretty much done here. If this video helped you out at all, maybe hit that like button, and consider subscribing for more content just like this. You can follow me over on Twitter and Instagram if you'd like, links below. And with that, I'm Josh from 91 Tech, and I will see you all next time.